In this video, we find out how a magnetic space liquid might be used in the near future to blast away cancer. Welcome to the channel. To help us understand how a magnetic space liquid is going to help us fight cancer, we first got to answer this one very puzzling question.
What on earth is a magnetic space liquid? Back in the 1960s, NASA scientists had a problem. The next wave of advanced space missions needed spacecraft with the ability to restart their engines whilst in outer space. At the time, it wasn't yet understood how liquid propellants would react in the absence of gravity. Rocket designers had to make sure that the fuel, which might settle or disperse inside the tank, could still be pumped into the combustion chamber. The solution they came up with was to turn the fuel into a magnetic space liquid. These magnetic liquids are called ferrofluids. But what exactly are they? Ferrofluids are made up of tiny magnetic particles like iron oxide, nickel, or cobalt, suspended in either a water or oil-based liquid. What's so special about these liquids is that they become magnetized in the presence of a magnetic field. This effect is then lost when the magnetic field is taken away. It all started with the work of three independent research groups, with arguably the most famous being led by one of NASA's top scientists. Stephen Papell was investigating how fluids behaved in zero gravity. He needed to overcome the challenge of maintaining positive fuel pressure, even though the fuel would just want to float around freely. He eventually came up with the ingenious idea of adding iron oxide particles to the standard rocket fuel. He then applied an electromagnetic field near the turbo pump to see what would happen. In zero gravity, this was exactly what NASA needed to encourage the sloshing magnetic liquid fuel mix to move towards the combustion chamber intake of the rocket's engines. This invention was so revolutionary that Stephen was awarded a cash prize of $15,000 from the NASA Inventions and Contributions Board and secured three patents for his bizarre creation. Now, the story of ferrofluids may have started with the production of simple particles of iron oxide, but today they come in a wide range of sophisticated varieties. The magnetic particles can be created in many ways, but using thermal decomposition, aka breaking down bigger solids into smaller ones using heat, and co-precipitation, the process of making these particles dissolve out of a solution into fine solids, are the most common. Scientists can also use a technique called thermal distribution if they want even more control over the particle's size and magnetic activity. Although the technology was originally designed to be used in rocket fuel, today you can find ferrofluids in all sorts of contraptions, from car suspension rigs, skateboards, hard drives, and even speakers. Artists also use ferrofluids to create hypnotizing creative works of art.
But perhaps the greatest use of all when it comes to magnetic liquids like ferrofluids lies in the innovative and breakthrough field of magnetic drug treatment in cancer patients. But what is cancer? And why is it so hard to fight?
Cancer is a disease that affects the cell's ability to function properly. Once the cells begin to malfunction, they start to grow uncontrollably, and in some cases can even spread to other parts of the body. Treatment often involves a combination of medical procedures, from surgery all the way through to chemo, radiation, and immunotherapy. One of the challenges is that removing tumors through surgery isn't always possible because of where it's located in the body. Chemo and radiotherapy, although useful tools that provide patients with a fighting chance, can cause highly unpleasant side effects, which is why there's such a great need for target-specific therapies, which, thanks to advances in technology, are now close to becoming a reality. So, what might these target-specific therapies look like? If you're enjoying this video, go ahead and hit that like button. Liking this video does wonders for the channel and helps to spread this content to more people just like you.
When it comes to new target-specific therapies, one possibility could be to use the invention of our good friend Stephen from NASA. That's right, scientists think that the solution lies in using ferrofluids that are bound by anti-cancer drugs.
The first set of experiments on human patients took place back in 1996. The experimental treatment involved two groups of patients. The first group took a conventional chemotherapy drug called epirubicin. The second group took the same drug, only in their case the medicine was bound to a magnetic ferrofluid. The medications were delivered through a standard injection into the veins, only the second group went through an extra step where they had a strong magnetic field applied as close to the tumor as possible for between 1 to 2 hours. The magnetic ferrofluid was successfully directed to the tumor site in roughly half the patients. Success? Well, not quite. Although the treatment seemed safe, the scientists concluded that more improvements were needed in order to make this type of procedure safer and more effective. Since then, studies of ferrofluid-inspired magnetic drug targeting appear to fall into the laboratory relegation zone. Nevertheless, this still remains a useful research tool in our fight against cancer. But there is perhaps another way to use ferrofluids to blast cancer cells to smithereens without damaging normal cells through an innovative technique called cancer hypothermia. Not to be confused with hypothermia, which refers to a drop in temperature. Usually when someone's body temperature gets dangerously low, hyperthermia therapy, or magnetic heating, involves using heat generated by ferrofluids when in the presence of an oscillating magnetic field. The idea is really quite impressive, and in 2013, nanoscientists Dr. James Hainfield and Hui Huang revealed the results of their early-stage trials. They used the same technique of injecting the magnetic nanoparticles directly into the bloodstream, only this time they engineered their nano-sized particles so that they were coated in a biocompatible shell to make it non-toxic to the body. This allowed the iron core to still react to the magnetic field whilst being kept safely out of contact with the body. Their master plan took advantage of a special property of cancer called enhanced permeability and retention, or EPR for short. This essentially refers to a weird ability that cancer tumors have to create lots of new blood vessels in and around itself. Since new blood vessels are more leaky than normal ones, the iron nanoparticles end up passing through the walls of these blood vessels more easily and accumulate in the tumor while staying out of healthy areas. After 24 hours, the tumors had 16 times the concentration of iron particles in comparison to the surrounding tissue. The next step was to apply a rapidly alternating magnetic field. This had the effect of causing the tumors to heat up to a lethal temperature of 60 degrees Celsius, causing the cancer to quite literally liquefy, leaving healthy tissue cool and unharmed. After a single 3-minute treatment, the tumors were completely eradicated, with the tests achieving a cure rate of up to 90% in mice.
So what does this all mean when it comes to the future of magnetic drug treatment? Well, it's currently restricted to scientific research purposes and is still awaiting FDA approval. Still, this innovative technique has shown promising results, and who knows, it one day could lead to one of the greatest breakthroughs in the history of modern healthcare.
And that's how a magnetic space liquid could one day blast away cancer.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that subscribe button and head to the comments section to share the ingenious ideas that you've come across too. For our offers and much more, head to the episode description below. And if you're looking for more great content, then check out this next video. Thanks for watching.